In this video, we're going to be talking about tattooed chefs' most recent earnings and my thoughts around them. I knew what your mom said. Like, you ain't with the time that you're gonna waste, don't wait. Well, I ain't gone yet, I'm in your driveway. And this is the last time you give me those eyes. I tried to hold you a little longer, but I like that I told you I was all the way. When we were heavy smoking in your right, it started snowing. We were way too calm to notice what I lost, cause we were all alone. It's in Portland, those songs were a Frank Ocean. We're too drunk and hopeless, too gone to know this.
Be thinking, Josh, why are you making this video now? Tattooed Chef's earnings came out almost a week ago. And me personally, I really don't like to put out any initial or I guess drastic thoughts, you could say. I really like to listen to the conference call, think about it a little bit. I like to listen to the transcript, think about it a little bit more. Then I'll go look at my notes. Then I'll put out an informed opinion based on all of that. And there's nothing wrong with putting out an initial opinion or an initial reaction. But me personally, I think a newer investor, maybe someone that's just starting to look into Tattooed Chef or someone that's just starting to look into the earnings of Tattooed Chef is going to get more value out of me doing a video like this, which a more informed opinion, as opposed to me just doing an initial reaction just based off the first time I listened to the conference call. So in saying that, I really hope you guys do get some value out of this. And if you do, make sure to smash the thumbs up button. Make sure to subscribe down below if you haven't yet. We finally hit 500 subscribers. Thanks to everyone that stuck around. Thanks for everyone that subscribed. This is only the beginning. There's so many more exciting things, so many more exciting ventures that are coming that I haven't even told you guys about yet. So if this is your first time here, welcome to the channel. Make sure to subscribe because we are going to keep making content. We're going to keep putting out videos, and I'm really excited for where this channel is going to go over the next couple of years. Anyway, what we're going to do here, we're going to go through the initial numbers that Tattooed Chef put out, the numbers that they did in this past quarter, and then I'm going to dive a little bit deeper into what was said in the conference call around certain things and kind of give my overall thoughts on it. So first quarter revenue, $52.7 million compared to $33.2 million in the first quarter of last year. That's a 59% increase year over year. Very, very nice. I really, really like that. Branded sales accounted for $36 million, totaling 69% of revenue, which is an increase of 105% year over year compared to $18 million in the first quarter of 2020. Now, Sam Galletti said on the conference call that they were hoping that Tattooed Chef would generate between 75 and 80% of their revenue from branded sales within the first 2 to 3 years. So the fact that they already have almost 70% of their revenue coming from branded sales within the first 6 months is a really good sign and something that I'm really, really happy with. And it really displays how fast this company is really moving. Sam also began to talk about on the conference call how many stores they're in and their points of distribution overall. And as you guys know, as I've talked about in the past, Tattooed Chef wants to be in 10,000 stores and they want to have 65,000 points of distribution by the end of 2021. Now, at the end of the first quarter, they currently have 6,065 stores and they are in 31,000 points of distribution. He also says he expects them to add another 1,162 stores and have another 8,000 new points of distribution by the end of quarter two. I personally really like these numbers. I really like what they did with these numbers. I really think it's very possible and very achievable to be in 10,000 stores and have 65,000 points of distribution by the end of 2021. No complaints. Very happy shareholder on that end. I really think that's a very achievable goal. And I really think it's going to happen. And I think this management team is going to execute on those regards. Gross profit for the quarter was $13.7 million or 26% of revenue compared to $9.2 million in quarter one of last year. Now, their gross margins did decrease slightly. They were around 27% this quarter last year. And for their gross margins, guidance was provided that they should be between 20 and 25% for the remainder of 2021. Now, here's something I want to talk about for a little bit here. And I think this is going to be important and why it's always so vital to make sure you're doing a deep dive into these earnings and make sure you're not just taking the headline up front. Because I think if a newer investor saw this number, that could lead to them panic selling or maybe an alarm goes off in their head and they're a little bit paranoid, whatever the case may be. And what I want to talk about is the net income for this past quarter. So they actually took a net loss of $7.9 million compared to $5.9 million in profit last year, as well as an adjusted EBITDA loss of $3 million compared to $7 million last year. So like I just said, some of you guys might be concerned about this, and I understand why when you take it at face value. But in the conference call, they also talked about how this happened and why it happened. So their operating expenses increased from $20.7 million to $2.4 million year over year, which is obviously a significant increase. You don't need to be a rocket scientist. You don't need to be a mathematician to realize that is a significant increase percentage-wise for this company. $3.2 million of that went to stock-based compensation. $2.6 million was due to marketing. thing. 2.6 million again was due to being a public company and hiring new employees, and 1.9 million was due to promotional expenses. Now I'm gonna come back to this towards the end of the video, and it's gonna even piece more things together for you guys and why it's so important to put a lot of money back into the business now for this company. But seeing how this net loss is allocated and where they spent this money, it really does not concern me. In 2020, we talked about how Tattooed Chef literally had no marketing, no ads, no commercials, literally nada. Now, obviously this company is growing and growing rapidly, and it doesn't matter if the company is growing rapidly or at a steady pace, eventually you're going to have to hire more employees and take on more overhead. It's just how business works, but it's going to be a lot sooner if your company is growing more rapidly like Tattooed Chef is. In addition, they did do a lot of promotional things. I know me personally, when I would go to Target to pick up some Tattooed Chef products, they did a lot of 2-for-5 deals, which obviously is going to hurt them revenue-wise. But the important thing to remember here, and the reason I'm such a big proponent of Tattooed Chef literally spending every single dollar they can right now, is because I think their main goal should just be to grow this brand as much as possible. And again, we're gonna get a little more into this towards the end of the video, but especially with consumables, you want as many people to buy that product and try that product as you possibly can. The main goal, from my understanding right now, is not to worry about profitability too much, especially in the short term. The main goal is to get this product out literally to as many people as you possibly can. Get it to Johnny, get it to Jimmy, get it to Stephanie. Literally get it to everyone and just have as many people try this product and just keep branding and keep marketing and just keep getting it out there. Obviously, at some point, you are going to have to worry about profitability, but I think as of right now, growing the brand, worrying about marketing, hiring more employees, and just focusing on overall distribution is what this company needs to be focusing on. Now, moving on, they also have $185 million in cash on this balance sheet. First off, that is a lot of cash for this company. I'm not sure exactly where this market cap is going to be by the time you guys are seeing this, but it's going to be around $1.5 billion, which is a lot of cash for this small cap company. Second, I think this cash balance is going to decrease a little bit once this New Mexico Foods distribution and Karsten Tortilla Factory deal goes through. Now, if you guys aren't aware, Tattooed Chef acquired New Mexico Food Distribution and Karsten Tortilla Factory for a total of $35 million a little while ago. Now, why would they do this? Well, first off, Sam Galletti said on the conference call that Tattooed Chef sees a lack of plant-based Mexican products. So they want to change that and they want to attack that sector immediately. And with this New Mexico distributors deal, they actually specialize in quesadillas, burritos, sauces, and more. And the fact that Sam said on the conference call that Sarah Galletti is looking into a full line of entrees to be rolled out by either the end of this year or early next year, in my personal opinion, this is a perfect weapon for their arsenal. And I really like this deal, and I really think it was a smart move and acquisition on this company's part. It almost seems stupid for them if they did not do this deal. Now, another important thing about this deal that no one's really mentioned, this deal gives Tattooed Chef an additional 118,000 square feet. Important. Now, Tattooed Chef is growing extremely rapidly. I think they're actually going to grow even more rapidly the back half of this year. But when you grow that fast, or when you grow at all, eventually you're going to need to upgrade and get more space and ultimately a new warehouse. And it's not cheap to do that by any means at all. So this deal is going to give Tattooed Chef more space. It's probably going to save them money in the long run, and they're just going to be able to ramp up production and store more product. Sam also said on the conference call that this deal could be adding $200 million of revenue over the next 2 to 3 years. Now, when I run my numbers on things like that, I personally try to run conservative numbers and think worst case scenario, because everything else that comes my way is a bonus. So let's look at it 5 years out, and let's say that this deal doesn't produce $200 million in revenue by 2026. That's an extra 20% in revenue. Never mind if this actually gets done within the next 2 years and this deal adds an extra $200 million in revenue by 2023. That's almost an additional 50% in revenue. Like I already said, I think this is a smart deal, a very, very, very smart acquisition. I support it, and I'm even more happy seeing this deal go through. Now, a couple of things to wrap up here. First, they currently have 42 SKUs. As we've talked about in previous videos, by the end of 2021, they want to have 62 SKUs. They want to have 54 SKUs by the end of quarter two. This company is not playing around. And they also said on the conference call that this was the most successful frozen food launch in Target history. Not in recent memory, Target history. And they say their growth isn't just revolving around new customers. No, it's revolving around, in addition to new customers, current stores wanting to add more SKUs. They did not have a single product discontinued at any store in this past quarter. Not a single one, not a single SKU. And I can see it when I go to Target to get this product, they're always adding more SKUs. It's insane, it blows my mind. You go back 3 or 4 months ago, no one near me had a Tattoo Chef product. Now, if you go back 2 months ago, they had 2 SKUs. I went there a couple weeks ago, they have 6 SKUs. Now, the second thing I really want to talk about here is the guidance. So, Tattoo Chef set their guidance for the full year at 235 to 242 million. And analysts were kind of picking at this on the conference call, and they were really trying to get something out of this management team because I think analysts start to believe that these numbers are not really relevant, I guess you would say, because I think a lot of analysts that were on this conference call are like, they could probably really accelerate that growth and really blow these numbers out of the water. I personally agree with that. I really think management is sandbagging these numbers, and I think there's a really great probability of them blowing these numbers out of the water. Now, why would management do this? Well, there's a couple of reasons I think that management would do this. First, they're obviously a newly public company. I don't even think they've hit the year mark yet, to be honest. I know they're close, but I don't think they've hit that year mark. So obviously, they really want to blow numbers out of the water. They really want to showcase their growth. That's the first reason. Secondly, with being a newer public company and a rapidly growing new public company, there's going to be a lot of moving parts here, which is fine, but that just means there's more room for error, obviously. So I think overall, management is just kind of leaving some leeway just in case they have any setbacks or anything goes wrong. But overall, as long as they execute, which I think they will, I don't see any reason why they would not. I really think they're going to blow these numbers out of the water, like I've already said. Now, the last thing I want to talk about in this video, and this is going to tie into the operating expenses and the net loss that I was talking about before, is a little bit about inflation. You don't have to be a rocket scientist to tell there is some serious inflation going on here. And Sarah Galletti was asked on the conference call if they had been seeing any effects of inflation, and Sarah responded with, they definitely have been seeing some inflation. But Sarah also mentioned they're contracted into their year-long pricing. So as long as corn regulates within the next 12 months, they should be fine. So what do you do like this? You, again, take the worst case scenario. So I really think Tattoo Chef management, what they're doing is they are bracing for severe effects of inflation. So in my opinion, that's just more of a reason to continue growing the brand, continue dumping money back into the business, and just really trying to get it to its highest point as you possibly can before inflation really starts to affect them, if it ever does. So look at it this way. Let's say there's someone that really enjoys Dunkin' Donuts. They really enjoy their coffee and they go there every single day to get a coffee before work. Let's say that coffee costs $3. That coffee goes up to $4. Do you really think that person that goes there every single day is going to break that habit of going to get coffee and is not going to go to Dunkin' Donuts anymore? Probably not. And I feel the same way with Tattoo Chef. I feel like if they just continue to put money back into the business and continue growing it and continuing to just push it out there and get as many people to try it, most people are going to really enjoy their products. As I've talked about before, their products are really good. A lot of the stuff I've had from them, I hate it. I hate it more than anything, but they just make it taste so good, it blows my mind. Like cauliflower, for example. I hate cauliflower more than anything in the world. Their cauliflower mac and cheese bowl, absolutely fantastic. Fantastic. Anyway, back on track here. Let's say they do see some effects from inflation. If they have enough people trying the brand, it's really been pushed out there enough, people are going to continue to go back and buy that brand, even if they do have to raise prices slightly. Anyway, final thoughts here. I was very happy with this conference call. I was very happy with these earnings. I thought there were some great things in the conference call. And it was very great to see that this management team is not getting complacent, because I feel like that's the biggest risk with this company, is if this management team gets complacent. Obviously, that's easy for me to say right now because the company is in its early stages, but still, it's still a good sign moving forward. As for what I'm doing with this stock right now after these earnings, I'm a little torn here and I'm not sure what I'm gonna do, because I really have a really good position built out in Tattoo Chef. If Tattoo Chef started going up tomorrow, I really wouldn't mind. I would be completely fine with it because I have really, really built out a solid position. But it's such a unique stock because it's just such an attractive reward and a very attractive risk, because I look at this stock and I'm like I said earlier, it's like around a $1.5 billion market cap. I look at it, I'm like, what are the odds of this company being under $1 billion market cap in 5 years? It literally seems like almost impossible for me to that actually become a reality, like literally almost impossible. So I am thinking about buying a little more. I'm not sure if I will, but I'm really considering it. But if, say I didn't have a position built out in Tattoo Chef, say I just started looking at this company and this stock went up, whatever it's been up so far, 6%, 7%, 8%. I'm not sure exactly what it's up off the top of my head. But if I wanted to start a Tattoo Chef position right here where it is now, around $18 or so, I'd be buying the stock 110%. I would absolutely be buying this stock, and I'd be buying it very heavy, in my personal opinion, if I did not have a position built. Keep in mind, that's not financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. I'm just a random guy on the internet talking to a camera in my room because I love making videos, I love making content, and I have a great time doing it. Anyway, guys, I'm saying that. That's gonna be it for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Again, thank you all for 500 subscribers. If you're new here, make sure to like and subscribe as always. Let me know what you think down in the comments of Tattoo Chef's earnings. I would love to hear from you guys in the comments, not the conference, the comments as always. And I will see you guys in the next video.